Hi, I'm Julie Hunt for Smart Kids 101, and today we're talking about saying grace, or a blessing at mealtime. I've been teaching my manners etiquette course, Polite Kids 101, for over 15 years. I do it because it's one of my deepest passions in life, to help kids be the best they can be. I know that encouraging them to live politely and respectfully makes not only a difference in their lives, but the lives of those around them. Now, in these Polite Kids 101 classes, students learn how to pass food around the table, serve themselves, and say, "I don't care for any, but thank you," when necessary. In one Girl Scout Brownie class I taught, I witnessed a moment I'll never forget. After everyone had been served, a little girl, just on her own, quietly closed her eyes and bowed her head. Without even being told, one by one, these little girls paused and either closed their eyes or bowed their head along with their fellow troop member. Oh, I was speechless. The response was totally unsolicited and was strictly done out of respect for their little friend. I wasn't moved because I agreed with her prayer, religion, or faith. Honestly, I couldn't tell what it was or to whom she was praying. I teared up because it taught in 20 seconds what I wanted to convey in a 3-hour course, to always show kindness and respect to others. For many, saying grace before a meal is as natural as buttering your bread. Others express their gratitude for food, friends, and life differently. But no matter how each of us choose to express it, the lesson is as simple as can be. Number one, respect tradition. Whether it's your family's tradition or not, show respect to others by quietly letting them practice at the table what they choose. That's not so difficult. Number two, value friendship. These little girls' feelings were uncomplicated. If Susie wants to pray before her snack, what's the big deal? The least we can do is respect her. It wasn't voted on, challenged, or ridiculed. The girls valued their friendship, and it showed in their actions. Number three, behave well. It's always rude to be disrespectful to others, no matter what they wear, what they do, or what they believe. Adapting gracefully to whatever you encounter and showing respect and honor will always be the ultimate in good manners. I'm Julie Hunt for Smart Kids 101. Thanks for watching. And if you like what you've seen, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel. That way you'll get all of our videos as soon as they become available.